8,265 pounds. This is beautiful. This is a, it's got 316 RKS and Terra, made by the Cruiser RV Company here at Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan. Just came on trade, and just a beautiful, beautiful day. This is a perfect day for camping. They call it a 316, so it sort of implies a 31 footer. This is a, I know from my experience, just in this business, this is probably closer to 35 foot tip to tail, but it's gorgeous. It's kind of what I call a flat deck fifth wheel floor plan. You've got dual opposing super slides in your living space. You've got a full bedroom slide up front, but they did something really nice. You notice it has a full pass-through storage. Many, in fact, most, travel trailers with a bedroom slide, they sacrifice the full front pass-through storage. These guys didn't, and I think they kind of took a note from the Coachman Freedom Express family of travel trailers that we sell here at Haylett RV. They do that all the time. So you've got a full normal travel trailer pass-through, and then you still have the outside access to the storage under the bed. But what I like here is they segregated this for an indoor-outdoor storage pocket, so that you have all sorts of good exterior storage. We've got power awning, power tongue jack, four corner power stabilizers. This is actually like a triple coated automotive painted nose cap. It's got just like you see this like cream with an accent dark color below that. You're gonna see that color pattern repeated on the inside as well. And that's, I think, one of the things I like about this. It seems and it feels like so many RV decor designers, they forget that you're getting inside and outside, and they don't make a match up. Look at the sheen still on this. This is a full high gloss, and it's still highly glossy, if you will. Folks came up from Indiana to work with us here at our Michigan dealership, so you got to be doing something right. But then again, when you've got all these service bays and the ability to do anything and everything and offer all sorts of products, you sort of have the ability to bring folks in from a long way. This has like a fifth wheel roof and floor structure insulation package. It's a sharp product. Previous owners did a couple nice things. Oh, I was talking about decors. A lot of brands, like, the exterior looks nice, but the interior looks like it came out of another camper. They made the inside and outside on this one flow, and it all blends together nicely. They did a bolt through hitch system on this little Reese guy on here. So this is, now this is not like full on welded to the chassis. This is not made for towing. This is a little accessory hitch if you want to add bike racks and stuff like that. They did a nice job of it. Underbelly enclosed, heated, LED tail lights. I mean, it's got it all. This thing has a lot of good going on. Frameless windows on the side walls with sliding windows on the slide walls, and that gives you good airflow, but it also gives you these crazy good looks. Like the frameless windows, it hides the seal under the window pane right here is what it does, so that the sun can't get to it, because this is obviously a very heavily UV tinted pane right here. It keeps your seals from getting chalked up, burned up, all that. Little grill quick connect down here. You see that you have a spot you can hook a grill up right there, and a nice little outdoor TV hookup station all under your patio awning. So you've got a perfect little campsite situation going on. Keyless entry pad. Nice part about that is, like, if you're going to go on a bike ride, you're going to go kayak and whatever, you don't have to worry about like the keys falling out of your pocket to your camper. Something Cruiser's done well for a number of years, and a lot of brands do this, but I've always liked how Cruiser did it. The way they locate their control panels have always made sense. And I like that they have a battery disconnect switch right here, because like your water heater, your slide outs, your awning, your air conditioner, fridge, microwave, water heater, everything goes into standby. It doesn't turn off. It goes into low power mode, not no power mode. But that battery disconnect hard kills it so that your battery doesn't go dead on you. But this is what I meant. You've got that same real smooth, creamy, light, dark peanut butter chocolate contrast going on in here that you saw outside. And it's just very pretty. I'm not good with words in that regard. I know that I yak a lot. But actually, there's certain things that I'm deficient with, and that's kind of one of them. It's got a real smooth, good look to it. They did a nice job in here. this is a couple's coach. You've got a nice freestanding table set up here. It does have the extension leaf for guests. And because this is a floor flush slide, you can kind of kick those chairs out a little bit and have some more elbow room. You've got your twin barrel chairs over here to swivel and rock around and get comfortable. And one of the things I like about these is this is an interesting rear, kitchen, middle, living room. And that is opposite of industry standard in dual opposing slides. Traditionally, you get middle kitchen, rear living room in most things. They flip this one around. So this, to me, if you're going to leave something parked somewhere for an extended period, this is a beautiful floor plan for extended season or seasonal, like park camping. I love this. I love this little pseudo-residential, like sectional style wraparound sofa. You've got some bonus storage below it. This is the perfect lounge right here, because I can see with my back to those cushions, with my left leg sticking out, I can be hanging out watching TV. I can have a cold drink of my choice on the counter right behind me, those beautiful solid surface counters. They did a nice job of all the woodworking in here. I'm looking at the viewfinder on the camera. It does not do this thing justice from where I'm sitting right here. This is definitely an RV that it will look better in person than it looks in pictures, and that's not normal, you know? All the original electronics are present and accounted for. Previous owners actually installed a bedroom TV and left it behind, so that should give you an idea. These folks were not scavengers by any means. They're good quality people. Electric fireplace. So that you're not burning up all of your propane just to get a little, heat in the spring and the fall. And by the way, that does have just like an LED ambiance light that you can turn on to make it look like the fire effect even without the heat going. Something I want to point out, because it will mess people up. These are dual posing super slides. This is not a traditional layout you find in this business in fifth wheels or travel trailers. It's actually somewhat reminiscent of the giant 388 RKS open range, or Highland Ridge, if you will, fifth wheel that we have here, where it's got this big rear kitchen with some seating on this side of it, but all in a one big super slide. But this little divider wall right here, it defines the living room from the kitchen, and the long peninsula that sticks out with all that beautiful prep space. There is no such thing as too much counter space. That defines, hey, the kitchen starts here. And I like that. I like that the campsite cook can be doing their thing, but you're still involved in the social matrix of the camper, if you will. You're still involved in what's going on around here. The lady of the house, I think she did a beautiful job with these little sayings and things that she placed all over. They're present, and they give it a warm welcome feeling. Like, look at this refrigerator that this little decal on here. That's nothing major, but it really makes you feel at home, And the little touches like over here, house rules. Number one, mom's the boss. Number two, see rule number one. Over here, we've got mom's kitchen and hours of operation, and it looks like most days she's out to eat. These are real backsplashes, which I like. It's not just like a sticker. And remember, guys, wherever you see countertop space, that means there's all kinds of storage below. There is so much storage in this kitchen. It's not even funny. Big cabinet space down here. Some handy overheads above. And I love these windows for light and airflow in a rear kitchen. Now, normally I would say this sink was in a bad spot, but they put it on an angle. And they gave it the little bump out right here, so it's actually very comfortable and very organic and feels right to use. They did a good job. This is definitely an RV, like I said, you have to put your hands on to fully appreciate, because just looking at pictures or even this video, I'm a little disappointed with how it looks in a video, but I think it's because there are so many good three-dimensional aspects to this floor plan that a two-dimensional photo or video, it doesn't capture the depth and the light and the senses that I feel in here. Something Cruiser RV's done for years is they have these press membrane cabinet doors. They're seamless, so they can't split going down the road. And they've always, for many, many years, have done these nice hidden hinge cabinets. So it's got such a clean look to it that's going to hold up long term. Yeah, they've done a great job in here. I'm really impressed with the look of this. And remember, guys, this is not a brand of RV that we represent here at Haywood RV. And I'm praising this thing. This is a well-executed decor, a well-executed layout. I'm very impressed with what they put together here. Excellent storage in this bathroom, too. That's a pet peeve of mine. When you start getting into these big RVs and they have no linen space, and that continues all the way down to the floor. So all your beach towels, your towels, maybe some extra sweaters, this could... some people use this as overflow pantry space, which seems weird. Like, why would I put a box of mac and cheese in the bathroom? Well, at your house, you wouldn't. But in a camper, you know, it kind of makes sense sometimes. We have a dual entry bathroom. You can get to it from the hallway where I'm at, or the entry door, or the bedroom. But entry door is on my mind because the entry door is next to us. So when you're traveling, or if you you just want to hop in and out of the camper real quick to use the bathroom, there you go. It's laminate flooring, easy in, easy out, easy clean, easy living. Queen bed, slide out in here. This cannot be upgraded to a king. That's a common question we get, so I like to try to head that off at the pass. And they borrowed a page out of Rockwood's book down here with the dresser drawers under the bed storage. That's that segregated inside-outside storage I was telling you about. That is a very deep bedroom slide, by the way. Many RVs, you have full 3-foot deep slides in the living room. Then they'll cut down to like an 18-inch deep slide in the bedroom. They didn't do that. This is triple deep slide. All three slides are 36 inches deep, and that drastically opens up this bedroom. You've got a huge, spacious, comfortable walkway area. You can actually stand here and get dressed is the thing. That's the nice part about it. This space is not for walking around. It's for getting dressed, and it does it well. Now, you've got that storage that passes through down here, but because there's a pass-through storage down there, it elevates the base level of the cabinets, or of the closet. And that creates a shelf that's easy to get to here. Now you can see we've got great, like, 8-foot wide hanging storage. Again, previous owners, instead of a tiny TV up here that's not good for anything, they wall-mounted and did a nice job of it. A nice Vizio high-def down here. It looks like they even added a little Blu-ray player to go with it. So they've added electronics that weren't even here from the factory level and left them behind. Amazing dresser storage too. What do we got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 drawers right there. That's a lot of drawer space. And the details. Previous owners put this in. They put a little door bumper so that your door handle wasn't going to bash a dent in the wall. Detail stuff like that from the previous owners. You know, it was well designed from the factory, and it was only loved and improved by the original owners. So here you guys have a beautiful late model, low use, well maintained coach at a very used price tag. And here's what's cool. You can get this at same as new RV financing. This model year can still qualify based on your credentials for the same RV rates as a brand new RV. New RVs can get better rates than used in many cases, and this can qualify for that. So you're buying pure value. You're not buying new RV depreciation. You know, there's something to be said for that. This is not going to last long. It won't be the least expensive used RV in our lot, but this is beautiful. Somebody's going to snag this and do well for themselves. So with that, take care, stay safe, have fun, and happy camping, everyone.